a tree and its fruit, the fruits of the prophet.
What are the best fruits?
When he says beware the false prophets, he says just see what influence they are having upon you. A tree is known by its fruits. Just see what their presence does to you. Are they really able to bring peace and lightness to you? Are they really able to remove fear from your mind, or are they putting you in greater fear? Do not know them by their forms, decorations, medallions, all the respect that society gives them. Do not use that to know them. Know them by one criteria only, which is what have they done to you? Have they liberated you, or have they put you in deeper bondage? That is the only test of a prophet. He liberates. Not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven. On that day many will say to me, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name and cast out demons in your name and do many mighty works in your name? And then I'll declare to them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of lawlessness. Take the name of God 1,000 times. It will not suffice. Only surrender does the trick. So you may do great deeds in the name of God. You may renounce, you may perform rituals, you may maintain routines, all kinds of penance, jap, mantra, tap. Nothing is going to help you. The single thing that helps you is the one who does the will of my Father shall reach him. Surrender to him. Let his will be your will. What does it mean to abide by the will of God? It simply means not to abide by your own will. Let your will be secondary to the truth. Find something so overwhelming and so immense that you can totally be devoted to it.